1 week from today, the Winter Olympics get underway in China. I talked about the upcoming games and her new book yesterday with Lindsey Vonn, the Olympic gold medal winning alpine skier. She holds 4 overall World Cup titles and is one of only 6 women to have won World Cup races in all 5 disciplines of alpine skiing. She retired in 2019 and is out now with a new memoir, Rise, My Story, which focuses on her trailblazing career. Lindsey Vonn, welcome to the NewsHour. Congratulations on the book. So much of your story begins with your family, how they've supported you throughout your career. You write so much about your father, how he encouraged you. He was a former serious skier himself. But I saw in the beginning of the book, you dedicate this book to your mother, and you say she was your inspiration. How so?
Well, my mother actually had a stroke while giving birth to me. And, you know, she's been so optimistic and positive my entire life. And I think that's where I've gotten that optimism from. You know, whenever I've faced adversity, especially physical injury in the course of my career, I always look to my mom for, you know, that level of optimism and positivity and also just a different perspective. You know, my mom had a limp because of her stroke, and she was never able to bike or run or ski with me. And so I just think, you know, I can come back from my injuries and my mother cannot. So it's a privilege for me to be able to work hard and come back and just, I don't know, having that perspective changed the way I approached injuries and the way I approach adversity. And that's why I dedicated the book to my mother.
Well, what also definitely comes through in this book is your drive, your determination to reach your goal. I mean, I know you've been asked this question so many times, but where does that come from? At 7 years old, you were saying you wanted to be a skier. When you were just 9, you said you were going to the Olympics. Where do you think it comes from?
I've always been a very driven person, but I think it also comes from my environment, you know, my family, my parents, my grandparents. You know, my grandfather was a very tough, strong man who had an incredible work ethic, as was my grandmother. And I'm spending a lot of time as a kid around them. And also, you know, again, my mother being extremely tough, and my father, you know, really ingraining in me work ethic. And I think that all of those people really shaped me, but the drive to want to be the best and to be a competitor, I don't know, that's something I've always had.
And Lindsey Vonn, you also write in detail about the physical injuries you've experienced over your career and how you powered through them and came back. You pushed yourself to the extreme. And as you think back on that, do you have any second thoughts about it? Because some of these injuries might have been life-threatening.
You know, I think unfortunately or fortunately, that's just the risk that we take in ski racing. And I've always known that risk. So I always have thought it's been worth it. You know, I love ski racing. I love the adrenaline and the thrill and, you know, going down a mountain at 85 miles an hour. I think there's really nothing quite like it. Have I paid a heavy price for doing what I love? Absolutely. You know, I'm in pain pretty much every day. My knees are always hurting me. My arm hurts. You know, everything is, but everything hurts. But you know what? I was happy that I was able to get as many years out of it as I did and to have the success that I did. I feel very lucky.
Well, in connection with that, you're also candid in the book about the emotional stresses that you've been under. You've talked for some years publicly about dealing with depression, but you know now we seem to be going through a period where more athletes are being more open to talk about their struggles. Do you think we're turning a corner in that way, or do you think there's still just a lot of stigma associated with it?
I still think there's a lot of stigma, but I mean, I started talking about it in 2012, and stigma was much greater than it is now. I mean, it wasn't an easy thing for me to talk about at that time, and many people said that it was going to ruin my career. But thankfully, it didn't, and you know, thankfully, we're continuing to have these conversations, and I think you know, with people like Simone Biles and Naomi Osaka and, you know, Michael Phelps and Kevin Love, you know, athletes speaking out about mental health only can be positive because it sheds light on a topic that, again, you know, has a lot of stigma attached to it. And hopefully we can change that and empower others to seek help and get the support that they need.
One other thing you write about is how women are treated differently from men in athletics. What needs to happen, in your view, for there to be a more even playing field?
I can't tell you how many people said that I got sponsors or I got certain privileges in my career because of my look instead of my wins. And I think that's completely absurd. You know, I've won 82 World Cups and I have many Olympic and World Championship medals. And that's why I was able to get the things that I did, not because of the way I look. And that would never be even a remote point of conversation if I was a man. So I think just those generalizations and those that type of conversation just needs to change, period.
A lot of work still to be done. I want to ask you about the Olympics this year, the Winter Games in China. As you know, a lot of conversation about whether they should even be being held there, given China's human rights record. The skier Michaela Schifrin said she had given it thought to whether she should go. Do you think if you were still competing, it would be giving you concern or pause?
I mean, it definitely is something that you need to think about as an athlete. I think that once the decision is made to have the Olympics at that venue, I think as an athlete, you can't say no. I mean, we've worked our entire lives for those moments, and I think there's very few people that would turn that opportunity down. But I think going forward, it's really the conversation needs to be on where we're, how are we selecting these venues? What's the reason? And, you know, really making sure, you know, we don't come into situations where there's a lot of controversy.
Of course, there's a lot of conversation about how different these Olympics are. There's COVID to deal with, but there's also the growing conversation about climate change. They're having to make the snow for competition in Beijing. You've started to speak out yourself about climate change, the effect of on skiing's effect on climate change. How do you look at that right now? And do you think it's something that there needs to be more discussion about?
I think a lot of athletes, especially skiers and winter athletes, have been talking about climate change for a long time. It just hasn't really been this dire until recently. But we've seen firsthand. I mean, I skied on glaciers in Austria since I was 9, and they basically no longer exist. They've melted that much. So, you know, I think we, just because we're in winter all the time, we see the changes and the inconsistencies, and, you know, it's raining instead of snowing, and there's so much volatility in the climate right now that it's very apparent to us. I'm glad that we're having these conversations, and I hope that, you know, we can make enough change as a whole to be able to offset this climate change.
Well, the book is, we are so delighted to talk to you about it. The book is Rise, My Story. Lindsey Vonn, we thank you, and we wish you the best.
Thank you so much. Take care.